I've been stranded here. 3 weeks. No sign of life. No sign of Gur. No sign of Danny. Or Vlad. Or anyone. I'm hungry. But my metabolism is slowing down because of the atmosphere. Wait just a flippin' second. Why haven't I thought of this before? I can try and call the food cruiser. Yes. Okay. I just gotta put in the model number of the food cruiser. Hurricane flight ship. Okay. Coordinates are... Alright. Should be brought in. And here we go. Food cruiser. Oh shit. There's so many damages done to it. From the impact. I don't know if this thing will be flyable. Damn it. I don't have the resources to fix it either. Let's just face it. I'm screwed. Well, I guess I better go record a holographic message and send it to the people of Earth now that I know that I can send things and get things from these computers. Is the camera on? Okay. Alright, let's do this. So, people of Earth, you guys are listening to me talk through this weird humanoid camera thing. Good thing I brought it in my backpack. This is it. I don't know what the hell happened. I'm not even sure if anyone on Earth is going to get this or even knows what's going on, but we were attacked. Viciously attacked by Caedem. And I'm not sure how to react to this, but if you guys are listening to this on Earth, don't feel bad about this. You know? Hey, it's okay. Part of the journey is the end. I think we all know that. Just for the record, being adrift on this planet for the past 2 weeks with no hope of survival and no food or water is more fun than it sounds. Haven't had anything to drink or eat for 2 weeks. I have no idea how to breathe. I'm thinking within the coming days I'll be dead. And that'll be it. Just know when I'm gone, continue on the legacy of the unit team. Gur is gone. Danny is gone. Vlad is gone. But there's still hope. I believe there is still hope. Not only for Earth, but all planets alike that have lost people due to Caedem's outrage. And if Uriah or anyone is getting this, stay safe. And don't let anything else happen. And if you find Caedem, you kill that son of a bitch. As for me, I'm going to head into my long rest. Getting kind of sleepy. Haven't slept in a few days. That's it. I'm gonna take a long nap, and I may not even see any of you guys ever again. But if I do, I'll shower you with all the gratefulness and hugs in the world. Zim out. Oh well. I guess this is... bright light. Who the... oh my. Mini-Moose.
Meep.
You're not so mini anymore.
Meep.
I've been through hell. How have you been?
Meep.
Gur. Gur's dead.
Meep.
What?
Meep.
I've been here for weeks. I just don't know. How are you here?
Meep.
The people of Earth sent you.
Meep.
Who?
Meep.
Of course they did. They still know I'm alive. Maybe the coordinates I sent somehow went back to Uriah?
Meep.
Yeah. And he figured out what to do. He sent the best person I could ask for, our moose. So, are you gonna take me back to Earth?
Meep.
That's damn fine. Let's get out of this hellhole.
Meep.
Crazy, Patrick.
Yeah, everyone's dead.
Poor Sandy, and Squidward, and Mr. Krabs. I mean, Mr. Krabs died a little while ago, but Gary, and everyone's dead. I wonder how Plankton's doing.
Yeah, Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy.
I know, our childhood heroes, Patrick. But I wonder how Patrick, or Plankton's doing. I know he was out of town on vacation, going to Egypt or something.
Yeah, and I still don't know what happened to Gurr.
Guys, look. It's the moose. They've come back. Jimmy, Sheen, SpongeBob, Patrick, Timmy.
Oh, hey, Zim. Hey, where's Gurr?
He's... Wait, did you guys not get my holographic message?
Oh, wait, yeah, he's dead.
So, you guys, all look like crap. But I should say I do too.
Oh, hey, we're not wanted fugitives anymore.
That's good, but Sheen, we gotta look at the bigger picture here. Half the universe is destroyed and dead. What happened to Uriah? I thought he sent Mini Moose.
Meep.
Well, you're gonna want to take a seat for that. Don't tell me he's dead. There's no way he's dead. He couldn't have perished because he sent Mini Moose, right? I sent Mini Moose. Why did you send him to me? It said it was. It was Uriah. I used the computer down Volcano Island. Yeah, speaking of Volcano Island, where is this place? Why are we on a coast? We're in California. Part of California. Why aren't we on Volcano Island? Well, after I transmitted that message, during me transmitting the message, it was clear and abundant that there was a huge battle on Volcano Island where Caedem's men attacked Uriah because the place was blown to hell. I mean, the volcano was destroyed and lava was coming up out of the floors, dead crabs all over the place. It was a massacre, although the computer was still working, so I was able to send Mini Moose. Mini Moose. Mini Moose. So, thank you for saving me, but We don't need you anymore.
Meep.
Damn, that was kind of brutal. Well, it's honest. I mean, I'm just glad you guys were alive. Is everyone else gone? Like, you know, what happened to Jenny?
Oh, I think she melted.
What happened to the toast guy?
He burnt to a crisp and then turned to toasty dust.
I lost my parents. I'm sorry to hear that, Jimmy.
Oh yeah, and also this famous science guy and his daughter, Professor Membrane, and his daughter, they also died.
Oh no. I knew them. His daughter was good friends with Roguger. Well, wait, what about Patrick? How are you guys alive and not dying without water? I used my magic. You don't know this, but before Jorgen, the most powerful being in the universe, died, he gave me all of his powers, and I enchanted SpongeBob and Patrick to be able to breathe without water. So, what's the plan? What are we going to do about this? Well, I'm afraid there's nothing we can do. How's Retroville looking? Sheen, you want to give him the news?
What news?
Of how Retroville's doing?
Oh yeah, that things are awful in Retroville.
Same in Dimmsdale. What about Bikini Bottom? Me and Patrick were kind of trying to avoid Bikini Bottom because it brings back flashbacks. We had a lot of our best friends die. Except the villain that we know tries to steal the Crab Patty formula has been gone for several weeks and is in Egypt somewhere, and we don't know where he is. Yeah, well, that's helpful. So, is this our new base of operations? You know, now that Volcano Island's destroyed? Yeah. Sheen, why don't you show him around?
Oh yeah, so this is the building.
Sheen, get up and show him around.
Alright, so we each have our own houses here. This is SpongeBob and Patrick's house.
Seems kind of dirty.
This is Jimmy's house over here.
Where?
Here.
Can I go inside?
Sure, I guess.
So this is where we're gonna be living? Like street rats and abandoned buildings?
Yeah, kind of. I think the Vanna, like, collapsed in all the chaos.
Oh, that's a shame to hear. My poor lab.
Oh, but that's your house. You get a really nice one.
But this house doesn't have my laboratory stuff. You know what I could be doing with my lab stuff, Sheen? I could be looking for a cure and somehow bring everybody back.
Let me go and then this one's my house. This one's my house.
Well, I'll look at your house after I take a look at what my house looks like. Well, I have to admit, mine's not terrible. I mean, I do have two floors and a kitchen and a basement, it seems.
Yeah, and you could turn the basement into a lab.
Hey, Sheen, come down here.
What is it?
Where are you?
What's in? I'm trying to find a way in.
Look at the basement. This place could come along. This will do as a new lab. What do you think?
Oh yeah, this is like, look, there's already some electrical thingers here.
Sheen, that's a radio and a VHS player. And a bunch of boxes that aren't working. This might be something though. I'll take a look at that later. What's over here? I'm assuming a vault or something.
Hang on, I think I saw some words on this. It says Imperium Refinery.
Wait. Imperium Refinery. That might come in handy with some work. Generators in case the power goes off. This place could come along fine as a new laboratory. What's up here? I guess this is just a place to sleep for the time being. Alright, let's go take a look at your house.
Yeah, we haven't really had a lot of time to move our stuff into our houses lately.
What stuff? Wasn't our stuff destroyed with the houses and the cities that collapsed?
Oh. Well, I was able to fish my computer out of the rubble, but I haven't really had time to set it up yet.
Oh. Does it still work?
I don't even remember the... Oh yeah, it still works. I even found a flash drive with some videos GURP pre-recorded. I was going to upload them. At some point.
Huh. Girl, still got videos. Could you send me a copy of them too?
Sure. Also, there's this thing in the basement. I don't know what this is.
This is what one of the pods that Caedem used to send out soldiers.
Bunch of soldiers could fit into this little thing?
No, it's just kind of like a GPS thing so the soldiers know where to go and attack. It makes me feel weird knowing that we're going to be all living in houses that probably belong to dead people that died from Caedem. But it's okay. Also, please do send me some copies of the GUR footage.
I'm trying to get the grating off so I can get out of the basement.
I miss hearing GUR's little voice, honestly.
Oh yeah, there are a bunch of those. There's finishing my Let's Play of Gone Home and my Let's Play of, what was that other game? Oh, by the way, that house up there on the hill is Timmy's.
Whose house is that over there with the barrel and the gasoline can?
Oh, that's just an old ship house.
I'll take a look at Timmy's. You can go back with the group.
Okay.
Thank you, Sheen.
No problem. What other game was I playing?
Just a jerry can, and some barrels and metal, and an old boat. I don't know how long we're going to be living here, but this place can't be where we stay. Well, I gotta admit, Timmy, you probably have the worst house out of all of us. I guess this is where he's gonna sleep. This would be kinda cool if it rained. Guess I better get back with the other group members. Well, gang, what do we do now?
Hey, look, there's a little green sausage on the beach.
Oh my god. SpongeBob, Patrick, is that the guy you were talking about?
Oh yeah, that's Plankton. Hey, Plankton!
You'd never know what a month trip in Egypt will do to you. Anyway, I got out of the water from Bikini Bottom. I wonder why Bikini Bottom looks destroyed. I mean, destroyed in a case that I didn't...
Oh, that's because some alien guy...
In a case that I didn't do it myself.
Oh, that's because this alien guy destroyed half of all life on the planet.
Who the hell is talking to me right now? I need to get
these things
out of my head. Get out of my head, voice.
No, I'm Patrick. I'm over here.
Get out of my head and please stop interrupting me when I'm speaking, because I'm trying to speak, but it just seems the voice is getting louder. Wait, who are those people up there? So, Plankton, I hope you had a fun trip. I kinda did. It was nice, but Egypt is just too hot. And I about died without water, but luckily us Plankton can somehow live without water for some reason. Anyway, I went back to Bikini Bottom and saw a bunch of things destroyed. I mean, it's like an apocalypse now. Remember when I had everyone controlled with the chum bucket helmets and turned the whole place into a planktropolis? It's worse than that. We know. Caedem's wrath. Well, that might not be the end of our discussions here. See, while I was in Egypt, I saw this archaeologist. I think his name was Tucker. I think that's what his name was. I found out that I went into this place. He went into a tomb and he died. But I went in there and I didn't die because I didn't set off any traps because I was too small. And I learned from Tucker's badge that he was a really good friend of Danny Phantom.
Ah.
So
what was in this tomb?
Well, that was the point I was about to make. This tomb seemed to carry a lot of weight. And apparently, this tomb holds something. And you want to know what it holds?
Ooh, what is it?
This tomb holds the very thing that started this whole damnation in the first place. A lot.
Caedem?
And I mean a lot of Imperium.
It's
a tomb, guys. It's a tomb that's powered by nothing but 100% Imperium. And I've been talking to some of my black market dealers that are trying to help me steal the Krabby Patty secret formula, no offense, SpongeBob, and they've told me that this Imperium can not only take lives, but resurrect them from the dead.
Guys. So this could bring everyone who died back to life?
Exactly. Correct. Guys, what
but
the hell...
About-
Shut up,
Sheen.
Shut up,
Sheen. Weren't they robots?
Shut up, Sheen. What if... This is our chance, guys. What the hell? What are we waiting for? Well, Jimmy and Sheen and Timmy and SpongeBob, Patrick, and Zim, you guys might want to take a back seat for this because it's in Egypt and it's far away, but if you guys really want to, I could take you. It just might take a while. No worries. I'm the most powerful being in the world. I can teleport us anywhere we want to go. But the problem with that is... getting inside the tomb without setting off any more traps. Oh no, the traps are all set off. There's some guy in there, in a robotic suit that looks badly damaged. He, set off a bunch of traps and was about to die, but then he used the Imperium from some weapon that he had, the remaining Imperium, to make sure he didn't die.
Jimmy, you don't think that was...
What, Sheen?
A guy in a robotic suit with an alien-looking gun?
You mean my son?
Powered by Imperium? Yes, I am talking about him.
I don't know. Timmy, you think you could take us to Egypt? Yeah, it'd be my pleasure, but... Are we sure we could trust this guy? SpongeBob, Patrick, didn't you guys say this guy has a track record of being a really evil ass?
Yeah, but he's only really ever tried to steal the Krabby Patty secret formula, and he's horrible at it.
Yeah, Patrick makes a really good point. He's not really a good villain. I mean, he is. He's a great villain when it comes to Nickelodeon, but he's just not that in tune with more of an evil side. I've seen him talk about this plan to destroy Bikini Bottom, but now that it's already destroyed, I don't think he wants to do that so much anymore. Guys, you gotta believe me here. I'm telling you the truth. There is a tomb in Egypt, and it's going to bring everybody back. But we gotta get there fast.
What was the tomb called?
I don't know. I saw hieroglyphics, and I kind of read it. And I saw someone by the name of Ramar.
Jimmy, ever heard of this guy? Ramar?
Yeah, I studied him.
Who was he?
Tell us. Tell us who he is, Jimmy! See, well... So, what is this Imperium, Jimmy? Or, who is this Ramar guy? Ramar was an ancient god who lived in Egypt but was forgotten by many people of Earth. He had the ability to control any given energy there was, kinetic, all types of energy, except he mainly fed off of one energy source, but we never figured out what that was in school. I guess that one energy source would be Imperium. But I've read somewhere that his tomb... It doesn't work unless you have Imperium to provide for it to come back and work. You'd have to strike enough Imperium into it for it to work and obey your wishes and commands. So, you guys want to go to Egypt?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I'd love to hear more about this Ramar guy, I mean, we only learned so much. Sheen, remember when the class took a field trip to Egypt and we encountered mummies?
No, I think that was just me, you, Carl, Cindy, and Libby sneaking off to Egypt to do a beach party.
Oh, yeah.
And then we found a tomb and found out that Libby was the descendant of a pharaoh, and then she got a new hairstyle.
Oh, yeah. Man, I used to be the smartest person in the entire Nickelodeon universe, and now I've just become dumber as I've gotten older. But now I remember, it was during that really long, boring video about Egypt, right?
Yeah, I think they were just talking about sand or something.
Alright, guys, that's enough talking about sand in Egypt. We need to get there now if we want to get this to work. That guy there, whoever this guy is, apparently Jimmy is your son. He might have already destroyed the tomb or put enough Imperium in it to do whatever he wants. Imagine if he put enough Imperium into that tomb to obey his command and he wipes all of us out of existence. What do we do then?
Well, I'd have think he'd have done it by now and we wouldn't be standing here having this conversation.
You're right. Let's get to Egypt ASAP. So, how do you guys want to do this?
I guess we could do two at a time.
No. We'll just do us two, Sheen. You guys stay out here and keep watch.
Alright.
Sounds good, I guess. Stay safe. If you see anything.
Come on, Jimmy. Let's do this. The two amigaps. We would have been
that.
The.
Don't say three. That, Sheen. That just makes me think about Carl. Wait, Sheen. Get out a weapon.
Oh. Wait, hang on. There.
I don't see any traps. What if Plankton was lying?
About the traps?
Or about
because
anything.
I don't see any traps. I don't see any trip wires or pressure plates.
I just said that. You go up there. I'll go down here.
Now this just leads back outside.
Sheen, I found something. Hello, Father. Caedem, I'll deal with you in a minute.
There's a lot of fire.
What is this triangle thing, you think?
Maybe it was an altar for some artifact, the art something.
I know these hieroglyphs.
What did they say?
These were the hieroglyphs that we saw in my textbook when I learned about Ramar. This is Ramar's tomb.
Okay, well, what do the hieroglyphics say?
Those who
do they
worship...
say something about a VCR?
No, it just says those who worship Ramar. Satan's Gate, something like that. Just a bunch. It's an oath. If you say the oath, it's supposed to bring things back to life. Caedem.
Well, feels like there should be something shiny on this pointy thing.
Son, Father. Skip that kind of talk. You hear me? I'm not your father. Okay? I have no words for an honorless man like you. What happened to your suit? It malfunctioned. I walked through a bunch of traps. I set them all off. It nearly killed me. What are you doing?
Well, at least now nobody has to worry about any more traps.
What are you doing here, Caedem? I came out to live the rest of my days here. My ship was destroyed. By who? I don't know. Some red guy with an abnormally large chin. Anyway, he...
That sounds like a superhero to me, whatever. I don't know what you're...
Anyway, what happened, Caedem? I'm here now. And I'm at the cursed tomb. What did you do with the remaining Imperium? Where is it? Did you put it inside the tomb? Did you wish for something? No. Where is it? It's in the Zila. And where's
the
Zila?
Where's the Zila?
It's gone. Reduced to atoms.
Oh, I think Zim's been meaning to destroy it, actually. Because it's really dangerous.
Well, that's besides the point, Shane. How did you destroy it? You literally used it 2 weeks ago to destroy all life, half of all life on Earth, and everywhere else. I used the Zila's Imperium to destroy the Zila's Imperium. That's how that whole thing worked. So now what? You're just gonna live here? Now we both get what we do. Now we both can't get what we want. Sheen, this is a bust. What do we do?
I say we bop him till he pops. I don't know if that was a good thing, good phrase or not. Thanks, same. Grate your crowbar. We got
Stop.
Some pinatas.
Stop. As much as I'd hate to admit this, I don't want to kill him. He's my own son.
Oh, you yeah, well, this. I get that.
You did this to me, Father. You made me this way. You and that awful excuse of a mother. Don't talk to her like that. It's true. And you know it. You knew you hated the way she treated me. Uncle Sheen?
Yeah?
Don't. Let's get out of here, Sheen. This is a waste of time. Hey. I'm sorry, Father. I'm sorry. As much as I'd hate to admit it, I regret it. I regret destroying half of all life. Father, you're never gonna bring them back. You're never gonna bring them back. They're gonna stay dead forever. And there's nothing you're gonna do about it.
Patrick, they've been in there for a long time. What do you think we should do?
I don't know, but hey, look, there's Sheen.
Hey, guys, turns out it was a bust. Caedem destroyed it.
I'm here. Did you tell him?
Oh, yeah. And Sim's actually pleased about the Zila thing.
Yes, I am. I wanted to destroy it, but I wanted to use the last of its power to bring everybody back.
Well, can we find some Imperium somewhere?
No. Jimmy?
Well, what about that Frankton's black market?
Plankton. My name is Plankton, and my black market dealers died. Zim? You think if we gave you time, you could rebuild your lab and see what you could cook up? I don't know. Jimmy, it's a lot of work. It would take a long time to rebuild everything that I had in my lab. How long? Maybe 3 years? Ah, Jesus.
Well, I'll go start a Kickstarter.
It's no use.
All in favor of a Kickstarter, say aye.
No one. No one's for your Kickstarter, Sheen.
Indiegogo?
No.
Come on, guys. GoFundMe?
No!
Patreon?
Just stop! We're going home.
machine?
It's open.
Hey. One button.
Hey. Huh?
One.
Hey.
So, I know Zim's been gone for almost a year now, but I've made some progress on the something that we can use to maybe try and put it back. But the problem still lies with the machine. I've tried everything, you know, meeting with black market dealers and trying to search for it through. Other people can't find any material. It's very scarce. Most people don't know how it is.
Yeah, that's the problem. Don't you just wish you could just, I don't know, go back in time and get some when they still had it?
I do. Don't think realistic. Keep your head up.
Yeah?
Keep your head up.
Oh, okay.
We'll figure out a way to do this. Say, you haven't been over to my house in about 6 months, but you want to come over for dinner tonight?
Oh, yeah.
But it's more rain. Probably fix that hole in the roof, too.
Mm-hmm.
You do know that it's 8:32 in the morning, right?
Oh.
I mean, you can come to my house if you'd like, but dinner won't be so much later.
Ooh, this is some nice computer stuff.
Yeah, this is what I've been using to try and see if I can get other people back. Have a seat. Listen, I'm gonna be going to work in a little while. So.
Okay.
You know, help yourself, whatever. I still gotta. I mean, it's been 3 years. Zim left, and about 2.5, Timmy left, and SpongeBob and Patrick just left last week. I gotta clean up their house still.
Uh-huh.
But listen, you know, I want you to know something. Just in case, I can't bring anybody back to my computer mumbo jumbo. If I can't, this is our last hope. Okay? There's no way Zip is gonna ever come back. And I don't think Timmy can wish anybody back to life or wish the pet more period. I would have thought that if he could, he would have already done that. But, you know?
Hey, remember that time you made a time machine?
Yeah.
Do you still have it somewhere?
Was that my old lab?
I was thinking maybe we could use that. Go back in time and do something about this.
Not a chance. My parents' house was sold. They died in the snap. So, chances are my lab was destroyed or was just never found. Could dig it up. They've called the cops. But I just want you to know that if this doesn't work, I say this, but we're going to have to live our lives. The world is in our hands. We have no other way to go back to anyone if this doesn't work. We have to make it work, and we have to do what we can, because this is how we live now.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, I'm gonna have to work.
Thanks, Sam.
Did you meet your dad this afternoon?
Sheen, I'm home. Come to my house.
Okay.
So I got to thinking. You know how you know how my job is a motivational, right?
Yeah.
I've been thinking. No matter what happens with this new project I'm working on, we're gonna get those people back to that one.
So we gotta go get the guys?
I don't know. We're gonna see what happens with this test I'm running, but all I'm saying is every day I have to go to work and tell people that we have to move on. And some do, but not us. I don't see ourselves getting out of this position.
Okay.
With the damage that my son did, we did what we could. I'm not even sure if he's still alive anymore, but we're gonna do what we can.
Okay.
How about some dinner?
Yeah.
I'll make that. This appears to be the house of Timmy Turner. Why is Crimson Chin at the house of Timmy Turner? I have been sent here to look for Sheen. Sheen Estevez. Timmy Turner. I must go now. I am the Crimson Chin. I'm here to look for Jimmy Neutron. While shooting fire out of my chin. Jimmy Neutron! Sheen Estevez, if you are here at this establishment, please show yourself.
Do-do-do-do-do, breaking all the windows, do-do-do-do, for no reason, do-do-do-do-do. Whoa, fire, there's fire.
Hello, is anyone home?
Fire. Yes, I'm home. Who set me and my house on fire? Oh my gosh, it's a big guy with a big chin.
You, what are you doing at the establishment of Sheen Estevez? And Jimmy Neutron. Stop trespassing.
Being Sheen Estevez?
You are the one that calls Sheen Estevez.
Yes.
And if you're Sheen, where is Jimmy Neutron?
He's at work at a therapy group. Fire, 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 fire.
I'm terribly sorry about that. It's just my powers acting up. I could control Earth, too.
Shade, come here. Let me show you my powers. How about a giant rock?
Yep, that's a rock.
How about a bunch of rocks?
Yes, a bunch of rocks, but question. Why are you here?
Well, Sheen Estevez, that is a great question that I would love to answer. And why don't I just answer it for you right now? How about that? Would you like that? Would you like if I answered why I'm here, Sheen Estevez?
Yes.
Well, Sheen, if you would like to know why I'm here, come to that house on the hill. That looks fine up there. This looks pleasing. This looks promising. Look, it's got a tire swing. What? You can't go wrong with a tire swing.
Yeah, well, why are you here?
Well, let me tell you this. This tire swing is a hoot.
Okay, but why are you here?
Okay, but why is this tire swing not here? I mean, what? I'm glad it's not. I'm glad it's here. It's a tire swing. Okay, the real reason I'm here. I'm assuming you are familiar with the cursed tomb of Ramar in Egypt.
Yeah, we used to bring everyone back, but there's no more vibranium left.
What the hell is vibranium?
Oh, it's this mineral thingy that does all sorts of stuff.
I'm pretty sure vibranium is a mythical element that exists in the Marvel Universe.
Oh, wait, no, it wasn't vibranium, it was Imperium.
Yes, Mike wouldn't get that brain of yours checked out, lad. Anyway, this cursed tomb of Ramar, it's a tomb in Egypt, and I'm sure you're aware of it. It's able to bring back dead and kill people, too. You could use it as a curse, or you can use it as a blessing. But in this case, I would like to use it as a blessing and bring everyone back. See, Sheen, I was sent to this universe with one person in common. Do you know of a Crocker?
Yeah, I think he was Timmy's old teacher.
Exactly. Crocker sent me to this universe. In my universe, Crocker is a good guy.
Okay.
In my universe, I'm also the good guy, and we become really good superhero best friends. Except he has the power to travel between dimensions. And with that being said, he sent me here. Because our world is at stake too. Because of something. And let me tell you what that something is. Are you familiar with Jimmy Neutron's son, Wilson Neutron, otherwise known as Caedem?
Yes, he destroyed all the vibranium, and that's why we can't use the tomb to bring everyone back to life.
Imperium, son, not vibranium.
Okay, sorry, I keep confusing it.
Here's the thing. When he used that Imperium generator to destroy parts of this Earth, he tore a hole within dimensions and basically destroyed other dimensions as well. All the dimensions. Well, they kind of are screwed. Put it them. But here's where the good part comes in, team. See, I'm not so bad of a guy. And, you know, I'm a superhero where I come from. And I'm coming here to give you the opportunity of a lifetime. How would you like to help me rebuild the cursed tomb of Ramar?
Yeah. Yeah, how do we do that?
Well, it's very simple. We need Imperium.
Yes, but there's no more Imperium.
Well, here's why you're wrong. We have the ability. You and me, we are people. Except I'm better than you because I'm a superhero. Anyway, we have the ability as people to tell you what to tell you. I want you to keep it between everyone. Because you don't know this, but Imperium has played a large role in a lot of your history here on Earth. You just didn't see it.
Okay.
Imperium was in a lot of your battles as mortal and human. For instance, I don't know if you remember, but in 2016, I do believe it was about 6 years ago, there was an attack in New York.
Yeah.
Know what I'm talking about? The Urkans invaded?
Oh, yeah, and then Zim and Gur stopped them.
Yes, the Urkans invaded and they attacked. There was a large portion of that that was controlled by Imperium. Those ships, those Urkan ships, had so much Imperium in them. They were fueled on basically Imperium.
Cool, yeah.
So are you seeing
what
I'm thinking
about? Magu? Did Imperium have anything to do with Magu?
Oh my god, Sheed, you are a genius. Yes. Maybe I mistook your brain power. Because Magu is a being of pure energy. What kind of energy is it? Take a wild guess.
Imperium?
That you are correct, my son.
Well, does that also mean that Uriah was made of Imperium?
Actually? No. I know it's weird considering they're brothers, but that's not the point. Are you seeing what I'm getting at here? What I'm saying is that we have power, and we have Imperium, but it's just not in front of us like that we should have it be. What I'm saying is, we need a means of time travel.
Hey, I was just talking with Jimmy about that earlier.
Yeah, I'm surprised. It's great you were talking. Because it's what needs to be done, Sheen. When exactly... it's 10:42 in the morning right now. When does Jimmy get off work?
Around 5?
Well, do you mind if I stay here with you until he gets here?
Sure.
I've seen this version of Jimmy. He was super smart as a child. And he did build the time machine. But as he's gotten older, it seems puberty has hit him hard because he's not as smart as he used to be. So in order to build this time machine, we're going to need a lot of power. Brain power, then. With that being said, we're going to need the help of the only one I could see fit to build a time machine with Jimmy. And that would be Zim. So,
Zim.
When we break the news to Jimmy, he's going to want to build it. But here's the thing. He's going to build everything he can in his power for this time machine. And while he's doing that, you and me are going to go and recruit the other members of the team. Timmy, SpongeBob.
Yeah, but I don't know. When Gur died, Zim kind of lost it.
He might come back. You never know, Sheen. If he knows that he is humanity and everyone else lacked hope, and he has a shot of bringing Gur back, I'm sure he'll join him.
Okay.
So... now you know who I am.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna have a look around. I have never been to this. How long have you guys had this place? 3 years?
Yeah, 3 years.
You guys kept it somewhat shape, I guess. Was it like this when you guys got here?
Pretty much. Zim used to live in that house up there. SpongeBob and Patrick used to live in that shed, and Timmy used to live in that house on the hill.
Show me around Zim's house. Give me a tour.
Okay. Yeah, we'll start in the basement, actually. This is something important in the basement that I think might help. This Imperium refinery.
Does Jimmy know this exists?
I don't know. I think I forgot to tell him.
Gee. This could be what he needs. This is going to help us build that time machine. We'll come back to this later. Give me a tour of the rest of the house.
In whose house?
Jim's house? Said this was Zim, right?
Yeah, the rest is Zim's house, yeah.
So, from what I understand, Zim left right after you figured out that Caedem had control of Egypt, right?
Uh-huh.
So he left about 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And what I understand that Timmy left about 2 years ago?
Yep.
And SpongeBob Patrick left last weekend?
Yep.
Okay. Did Zim tear these holes in this place due to him being sad about Gur?
Oh, no. These were here when we got here.
Oh, okay. What did Zim do while he was here? Nope.
Pretty much try to get some of the stuff in the basement to work. I mean, we won't know if the Imperium reactor works unless we have Imperium, but
okay. Tour me of SpongeBob and Patrick.
Uh-huh. It's a shed with a generator and some medical kits.
Okay, and Timmy's...
Oh, we were just up there at Timmy's house, isn't it?
I didn't see the inside.
There's a ditch. This is must be his bathroom. There's a bucket.
So, Zim left because he was broken about Gert.
Mm-hmm.
Why did Timmy leave?
I think he was pretty sad that he couldn't use his wand to bring anybody back.
And what about the other two, SpongeBob Patrick?
They decided they'd been away from home long enough, so they went back to keep managing the Krusty Krab.
Okay. Well, thank you. I'm gonna... I don't know. We're gonna have to wait. It's only 11 o'clock, so we have a while. Want to get some lunch or something?
Sure.
There, I can tell you more about Cloud. Whose house is that down there?
Oh, that's just an old boathouse.
Did anyone there's ever an use old it? Boat like, in did it. Use it as lab or anything?
No, there's a boat in there, but it has a big hole in it.
Oh,
yeah, there's a big hole in it.
Okay. Let's go get some lunch. We'll wait for Timmy.
Mm-hmm.
Gene, I'm home.
Oh, that's him. I'll go get him.
Good.
Hey. Jimmy.
Gene.
Hey, Jimmy, I really, really need to show you something.
Where are you?
I'm outside looking for you. Where are you?
I'm in your house. And I'm in your basement. It's filthy.
Oh, well, come up to the main part of my house.
Why?
Because someone's in here that might have the solution to our problem. The Crimson Chin from another dimension.
Hello, Jimmy. Yeah. Yes. It's me. I come from another world.
He says we can go back in time to get Imperium from the past.
So, Sheen's theory was real? Yes. Let me inform you on how this works. Sheen told me that he neglected to inform you about a certain refinery house.
Oh, right. There's an Imperium refinery in Zim's basement.
How long has it been there?
Since we got here.
Sheen, we had a ticket to time travel for 3 years, and you choose now to tell me?
Yeah, well, I didn't really know about the time travel until, like, yesterday.
That's not the point. Arguing is not going to get you. Here is the point, though, Jimmy. We are going to use that Imperium refinery to make Imperium. How is that going?
Apparently, a lot of our enemies have used Imperium, like the Urken ships and Magu.
So, Wait a second. So you're saying we do have to go back in time? Yes. Here's the problem. We're going to need something. And you know that you're not as smart as you used to be. Not a put down, but just that. But we do need to get Zim. Possibly. Zim lost his mind after Gerd died. He won't want to come back.
He knows what's well, if you tell him
if he knows what's at stake here, then he'll come back. Trust me, I know how these wives are from another. Not only that, but my universe is destroyed. If I have the will to come here to tell you guys about it, obviously you would have something. Wait. So, wait a second. How come you don't stay in your dimension and time travel over there and fix everything? This will only fix one realm. So if we do it here, it'll only fix it. That would mean that I would have to go back home and live back to half the universe dead. But where I come from, I didn't really have friends except for Crocker and he's still alive. So there's that. But on top of that, Caedem does not exist. I have a friend, Crocker, in my universe. He can dimension travel, but he doesn't need him, period. Not powered by him. So we're going to do this. We need to get him. But I need you to build everything. Find some scrounged up metal or something around this place. Build what you can. I know deep down you still got some brain power left in there that could build something. We'll get Zim to work on the circuit. So who's going to me and Sheen will be taking the liberty of recruiting our own members while you work on them. We'll be back. Stop interrupting me, Sheen, but what do you want?
Oh, I was just wondering. I know SpongeBob and Patrick are in Bikini Bottom, but where is Zim?
I'll tell you after I'm finished. It's Friday, so you're off for the weekend, right? Yeah. Yeah, I am, and I don't really get paid for it. I just like helping. This Monday. Yeah. Here's the thing. It's Friday now, and it may take us all weekend to recruit everybody. So, build it in one weekend? Absolutely. Okay. That's all I want. So here's the thing. When it comes to SpongeBob, Patrick, Timmy, Bulma, Patrick, they will be our first because they are literally right. And what about Timmy? Timmy's in Canada. Why is Timmy in Canada? He, as far as I'm concerned, he tried to start this place called Dimsdale 2.0, but it didn't really work, and he ended up making an underground sewage cult instead of. And Zim is currently in the Antarctic, trying not to go fully. So we're gonna get going. You do what you can. Sounds good. Gene, can I tap you outside?
Yeah, sure.
Can I trust you while I'm gone?
Yes.
While you're gone, I mean?
Yes.
So, this is a big burden. But you're my brother, and I want you to know that. So, here's the thing. You go out there and make sure everyone comes back, because we need everybody. Got it?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay, good luck.
Okay, I'll go get the chin.
Okay, I'm gonna go start on my project.
Okay. Right.
One more thing.
Yeah.
Have you ever been in water?
Have I ever been water where?
Underwater. Have you ever been to Bikini Bottom before?
Oh, yeah, I have.
Ready?
Yeah.
Then let's do this. Shin and Sheen, unite!
Yeah! Well, here we are.
So this is the Bikini Bottom.
Looks like they closed off downtown.
How long has it been since you've been here, Sheen?
A few years.
Alright, let's get looking for those spongy creatures.
Well, SpongeBob lives in that pineapple. And Patrick lives in that rock.
You get Patrick, I'll get the sponge.
Hey, Patrick! Patrick!
They aren't here. Wait a second. I spot something on a rock.
Squidward! No, he's not home either. Now, what's going on? Where'd he go?
I'm over here, Sheen. You don't know this, but, they put blue lights on all the houses of the people that perished in, Caedem's incident. Looks like this person didn't make it.
I think that was SpongeBob's driving teacher.
Looks like this anchor person didn't make it either.
Oh, that was SpongeBob's old boss. He died before Caedem's thing.
Oh. Whoever lived in that dome didn't make it either. Or the retirement home. There they are on that rock over there. Jane? Jane?
I came back to Bikini Bottom because I thought people would be mourning and still suffering over their losses. Because we've been up in the real world with Jimmy and all the others for 3 years, but everyone is... not here. Seems like everyone has moved out of Bikini Bottom for some reason.
Yeah, except for Squidward, but he's asleep in his house.
Patrick, what's the point of living anymore if there ain't anyone to live with? Except for you and Squidward, who doesn't care about anything. I heard his clarinet died in the accident.
Wait, his clarinet died?
Yeah. I guess he treated it as a normal person, and it was one of the fallen victims.
But it wasn't alive. It was a clarinet.
But he looked at it as his best friend, Patrick, and nothing can replace your best friend.
Okay. Hey, earlier over there on the road, did you see something that looked like Sheen and some red guy?
No, I think you're just saying things. But it's okay, Patrick. Caedem's accident makes me... see things all the time, too. Wait a second, now I see it.
Hello there, Sponge. And Patrick.
Hey, guys.
Sheen. Hey, Sheen.
What are you guys doing here? Who are you?
Oh.
I'm the Crimson Shin. I'm here because... I know how to bring everyone back. Yes, I know how to bring everybody back. What do you mean? Well, everyone that died, you know, in Caedem's wrath, I know how to bring them all back. How?
Well, I'll explain it all when we get back up to the surface world. For right now, I'm gonna need you to come with us.
Okay.
Come on, Patrick, let's get the hell out of here. This place gives me the creeps after everyone's gone. Are you sure we're going to be able to bring everybody back?
Oh, yeah. He has some cool plan that involves time travel.
Time travel? Are you guys serious?
Yes,
time travel.
Sheen, why are you treating this like it's such a big deal? What if we get stuck somewhere that we don't want to be?
Time travel.
Listen, he's gonna be like that for a while, so I'm gonna need you to come with me and come with me right now. We still gotta recruit all the others.
Others?
Yeah. Timmy, Zim. That's it.
Alright, come on, Patrick.
Time travel.
And there he goes. Let's follow him back up to the surface world. We'll have to go get the others from there.
Alright, Patrick, let's go.
Alright. Do you hear that noise?
Yeah, it's a zappy noise. Looks like it's coming from the boathouse. Or sounds like it.
You know, it sounds like Jimmy's working on that time machine like we previously thought he was.
Yeah, but it's coming from the boathouse.
Well, that makes sense.
It's like Jimmy's new lab.
Hey, guys. Hello, Jimmy.
Ooh, is this a time machine? Looks cool.
It is the time machine, Sheen. I have been working all day. Where have you guys been?
Bikini Bottom getting SpongeBob and Patrick.
Yeah. We were only in there for like 10 minutes. Yeah, well 10 minutes here is... Let's see. 2 days here. Or 10 minutes down there is 2 hours. 2 days here. Anyway, I can't get all that. Where are they at? SpongeBob and Patrick. Oh, they're coming. A little bit late, but they are coming. They said they would come.
So, do you know where Timmy is?
Yeah, I thought I told you guys he was in Canada. Zim's in the Arctic. He's in Canada.
See, I told you the first time. He's in Canada.
I was never informed anyway. Alright, we're going to Canada to get him. Alright.
Let's go to Canada.
Can I ask you a question, Jimmy? Yeah. Why is the time machine sparking and electricity-ing all over the boathouse? It's because I'm missing something. I need you guys to go get Timmy as soon as possible so you guys can go get Zim. Because Zim is the only one that's going to be able to figure out how to do this. And if Zim doesn't choose to join our team, I don't know what the hell we're going to do. Alright, Shane, let's go.
So, which way is Canada?
Oh, Canada is wherever your heart desires. But it's this way. Alright. As the power of the Crimson Chin, I grant you ability to fly.
Ooh.
Follow me.
Yeah, Canada. So, this is Canada.
This is Canada. It's extremely cold.
Mm-hmm.
My nipples are freezing.
Also, how are we driving this car without back wheels?
We do have back wheels.
I can't see them.
Well, that's probably because you're in the car. I think we should stop here.
No, I mean, Pikmin's in third-person mode, and he can't see them.
Well, I guess that's his bad.
And it honestly looks pretty funny.
Alright, Sheen, cut the funny business. We're here for one thing and one thing only. We're here to get that wizard back.
You mean Timmy?
He's a wizard, right? He has that stick of destiny or whatever?
Well, technically it's a fairy, but yeah, magic.
Fairy, whatever. Back in my day, fairies were wizards. Although I am from his world. I don't know how this works anymore. What do you suppose this Timmy person is, and why do you think he the hell he's in Canada?
Well, let's see. probably to be alone. And I would assume that he would be in a house of some kind. Because it is very cold out here, and if he stayed out here too long, he would probably die. Do you see a house?
I don't see a house, Sheen. Here's what I'm going to have you do. You're going to stay here. I'm going to go look the other way, where the car is. If I need you, I will call you. Keep in touch. Your walkie is very, very important. No need to walk when you can fly. Oh, okay. This makes a lot more sense. Sheen!
Huh?
Jackpot, come back up.
To the road?
Yeah. I found a Pine Creek Lodge that's no doubt abandoned after that whole thing with Caedem. Maybe Timmy's in here.
Mm-hmm. But, where is it? Because I just found the road.
This way, over here. Except it's locked, and the windows seem to be made of bulletproof glass for some reason.
Okay. They have a snowboard sale going on.
That's cool, I guess. We're not really here to snowboard. We're here for Timmy himself.
Timmy!
I couldn't find anything on the roof.
Dang, I gotta break your snowboards.
Sheen, come look at this. There's a bunker or a house on the road.
Wanna check it out?
Yeah.
Keep out. You go first.
Hello? Timmy? Sheen.
Hey, Timmy.
Sheen, what are you doing here?
Oh, this guy says he knows how to bring everyone back with time travel.
Why does this guy look like the Crimson Chin? It's because I am.
Oh. Yeah, from another dimension.
Okay, what the hell are you guys doing here? Did you not read the sign? It said keep out. That's what I wanted to stay. Please leave.
Yeah, but we need your help to bring everyone back.
Why? Why do you need my help? I'm just a failure. Every time I'm in battle, it seems like someone either gets hurt or lost.
Yeah, but this is your chance to correct it.
Why? Why do you need my help and my help specifically?
Because you're the most powerful being in the universe.
Well, here's the thing. The wand kind of broke. So I'm no longer any more powerful than any citizen that survived the attack from Caedem. I am nobody now.
Did you try gluing it back together?
That's not going to work. Sheen.
Tape?
No.
Gorilla glue?
No, just leave it at that, okay? I am no more. I am not a hero. I am a simple man, so I do not appreciate you coming in here when there's a keep-out sign to try and get me to join some fight that I don't want to join that'll probably end up with all of us dead. So if you want to have this death wish, you be my guest. I'm just going to sit here, enjoy my pizza, and drink my beer and play Fortnite.
Do you have any ideas?
I have one. Timmy! If you come with us, we'll give you an endless supply of beer and pizza. Yeah. What kind of beer? Well, we got all kinds of beer. We have beer of that kind, beer of this kind. What the hell is beer, Sheen?
It's alcohol.
You drink rubbing alcohol on this planet? No, it's a different type of alcohol. I heard you, by the way. Sheen, do you guys really have alcohol?
Yeah, I think there's some in my basement.
Okay. So, how does this work? You said time travel or something like that?
Oh, yeah, Jimmy's making a time machine, and then after we bring you back to where he is, we're gonna go get Zim in the Arctic, and we're gonna bring him back to help Jimmy finish the time machine, and then we're gonna go back in time, get a bunch of Imperium, and then use that at the tomb to bring everyone back.
You know, I could probably also use this opportunity to go back in time and try and find my wand.
Oh yeah, you can do that too.
Alright, I'll join you, but only because of the beer and pizza, and the possibility of getting my wand back, and saving everybody else. I had just gotten a call this morning that, for some reason, they chose to keep this from me for 3 years, but do you guys remember that girl I talked about that I kinda liked?
You mean Trixie?
Yeah. She perished in the Caedem reckoning thing. So did her parents. Okay, well, that's nothing we can't fix. You come with us, we're gonna get her back. Shane, I'm gonna get Timmy back to the island. You are going to stay here and wait for me to come back, and then we will be off to the Arctic.
Okay.
Alright. Timmy is officially back with Jimmy and the others.
It's kind of weird how you just spawn a house in the middle of the road from a spawn menu.
What? Why did you break the fourth wall, Sheen?
Well, if Gur's not here, then somebody has to break the fourth wall.
Okay. I'm going to grant you these flight powers again. Follow me. I know exactly where the Arctic is. Up we go! So, Shane, this is the Vitan base, as Zim calls it.
Okay, how do you know it's called that?
It came up on the GPS. It's been occupied by Zim since 2019.
Okay.
So now, I guess the only thing we have to do is actually look for Zim.
Oh, he's in there. Watching Gur's Let's Play of Potato Thriller.
Zim.
Hey, Zim.
Oh, Gur. Zim. Zim, snap out of it. Zim!
Hey, Zim, we know how to bring everyone back with time travel.
Who the hell are you two, and what the hell are you doing in my house? Get out of here.
I'm Sheen.
Who are you?
This is the Crimson Chit.
Huh?
I am Sheen.
Are we in Florida?
Is that a reference to that new Jumanji movie?
I don't know. What new Jumanji movie?
You know, where Dwayne Johnson is doing an impersonation of Danny DeVito as a very old man.
That came out 3 years ago.
Oh.
Well, who are you guys? Where are my pills? And where the hell is my grilled cheese sandwich? I think Zim has gone senile.
Hey, we can take you to your grilled cheese sandwich. We can bring you to your grilled cheese sandwich.
I will give you a heart attack. Zim, come on. We're gonna bring Gur back with time travel. We're gonna make this whole thing. Jimmy needs your help. We need to assemble the time traveling machine, and we need your help to do that. We need to put the final products onto it so we can actually do the whole timey, wimey, shimey thing. Are we in Florida? Oh, shit. You do this. I can't do this.
Okay. Zim, we are going to bring Grr, back with time travel. So we need the time machine.
You need help with what?
The time machine.
Doing what to a time machine?
Finishing it so we can go back in time, get a bunch of Imperium, and bring everyone back to life.
Who's Miriam? I don't know a Miriam.
No, Imperium.
Imperial Star Destroyer?
Imperium.
Yum, I'm not in the mood for sandwiches.
You just said you wanted a grilled cheese. Should we just grab him and put him in the car?
I got a better idea. If you fools don't get out of my house and don't get me a damn grilled cheese in the next 5 seconds, I'm gonna...
Oh yeah, that was a bit of a better idea.
Put him in the bag, get him in the car, we're out of here.
Okay, come on.
What's going on?
Shane? Where's the car? Where's the car? Where'd the car go?
Wait, Shane, what's going on to me? Shane?
We're taking you to make a time machine.
What about a time machine? What's going on? Why are you guys
here?
We're
gonna go back in time, get Imperium, and save Gurren and everyone else.
Why am I in the back?
Because I already called Shotgun.
So where are we going, guys?
We're going back to the beach. We're gonna make a time machine. We're gonna go back in time. We're gonna get a bunch of Imperium. We're gonna go to the tomb. We're gonna bring everyone back.
The tomb that failed so miserably 3 years ago?
Yeah, but we're gonna go back in time and get Imperium.
Whatever you guys say.
Where'd Zim go?
Zim's coming, he's just a little bit slow. I'm gonna go get Timmy those beer and pizzas that I promised him. As soon as Zim gets here, go ahead and go to the boathouse. I'll be there in a little while.
Okay.
I'm here.
Alright, so the time machine is in the boathouse.
Take
Let's
me to it.
Let's go to the boathouse. Hey, where'd this sign go? Whatever. Hey guys, I got Zim.
Where's he at? Hey, okay. There he is. Alright.
Hey, look, it's the green booger guy.
Yes, it is me. I'm Plankton. I thought you guys wouldn't notice me.
Why is he here? Well, we're back to Bikini Bottom to see if he could help us fix the time machine since you were gone for so long, but he said he didn't know what the hell to do, so now that you're here, what do we do?
So, Jimmy, I'm here to understand that you have basically done the basic fundamentals and built the time machine from scratch, right? Yeah, we just don't know what that sporking is, and every time we click the button to actually time travel for a test, it never works. Well, for starters, you might want to use the gas canister. This would probably help your situation a lot. You just want to stick that right there and make sure it's in there properly. Now you want to weld those two together. And any minute now. Sparks are gone. That's literally all I had to do. Yes, that is all you had to do. That's all that's made up this time machine, wimey, sparky things. So now the time machine should work. Okay, thank you, have a nice day. Can I go back and watch Gurr videos and pout and basically be sad by his death now?
Don't you want to help go back in time to get the Imperium so we can bring him back to life?
Yeah, come on.
Well, guess I could try.
That's the spirit.
question is, who's going to be the first to freaking go back in time? Well, I think we should discover a base plan first. Like, where are we going to go back in time to? Like, I know that Imperium has played a major role in a lot of the fights, but we need to go back to specific times. And we don't even know the fundamentals of time travel here. Like, what if
I know one place we could go back to. The Crimson Chin.
Sheen, I wasn't done yet. We don't even know how the fundamentals of time travel work. Like, what if we run into our past selves? That would probably cause an alternate branch reality to spark, and we don't want that because something could happen to this reality. He's got a point.
You want to know one place we can go back to? That thing in New York. The Crimson Chin said that the Urkin ships were powered by Imperium.
That's one viable option, Sheen. Well, I was talking about another area where apparently Timmy here went back in time with Gurr and went into a comic book world, and that comic book was, well, the thing that took them to that world was made of Imperium, and not only that, there was Imperium in the fight, and the Zilla was in the fight, and there's a lot of Imperium in that world, I guess.
Oh, and then there's also Magu. Wasn't Magu made of Imperium?
That's true. Alright, I'll be the one to help. But we need to discover where we're going first. I have an idea. Okay, here's my plan. Alright, listen up, guys. Huddle in. Come over here, Shane. Here's the plan. We're gonna go back to Dimmesdale, 2017, back when Gurr and Timmy over here went into the comic book and basically fuddled around and almost got killed by the evil Crimson Chin from that world. What we're going to do there, we're gonna have two people go there, and when we go there, we're gonna find a magic wand. The magic wand obviously has Imperium, according to Timmy, right? Correct. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to go back there. We're going to get the Imperium from that wand. All right, there we go. We have some Imperium there. Next, we're going to have another team of two people. After we come back from Dimmesdale, another team of people are going to go to New York, 2016. That'll probably have to be me, but it doesn't really matter, I guess. When we go to New York, 2016, we're going to have to search from all those ships because they are powered by Imperium. And when we do that, hey, we're in the clear. And next, we're going to go to Foodcordia from 2018, because Foodcordia was where Gurr lived for a while, and he fought those Sailor Moon girls, and after doing a little bit of research on them, I figured out that their power stemmed from some sort of Imperium-type beam. I know it's far from the source material, but we're just going to have to work it from there.
Yes.
Okay, next, we're going to go to Amity Park. Amity Park is where everything happened. Amity Park in 2017 is where Danny fought off Vlad because he filled Amity Park with a fog of souls. And those fogs of souls came from the ghost machine. And that ghost machine, guess what, was empowered by Imperium Sheen! And when we get that Imperium-filled ghost machine, we're gonna get enough Imperium, but not enough. So that's when we come back and we send another team, or we can all go to Glukaki Island from 2017 where we fought off Magu and extract enough blood from Magu to get Imperium, thus for creating enough Imperium to make the Cursed Tomb of Ramar viable again, to bring everybody back to life. Oh my god, I need a drink.
I wonder how those Sailor Moon girls are doing now. I think they're in Pikmin's plush videos. So that's something.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, who's ready to go back to frickin' Africa?
I am.
We're not going to Africa. I meant who's ready to go back in time.
I am.
I am. I think we all are. Question is, who's going to be on the teams? Alright, listen up, gentlemen. Do you guys hear me? Loud and clear?
Yeah.
Okay, so I think I have the teams decided. This is what we're going to do. Alright? Are you listening?
Yes.
Good. Okay, so this is what the teams are going to be split into. SpongeBob and Patrick, front and center. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So, SpongeBob and Patrick, you guys will be taking over Dimmesdale 2017 to go into the comic book world with Gurr and Timmy. Once you get there, try and find the magic wand, get the Imperium out, suck it out as much as you can, and then we'll bring you guys back. You guys will be first, okay?
Okay.
Alrighty. Alright. Alright, after they are back, That's when we send Zim and Plankton. I mean, Plankton and SpongeBob. All right? Ah! Me and Plankton will be heading to New York 2016 after you two come back. And once we do that, we're going to find a ship of some sorts. Any ship will basically work. And once that is done, we'll get the Imperium and come back home. Simple as that.
Oh. I have an idea. Maybe you should try to find a ship that you and Ger shot down.
That's a good idea. I don't want to be seen by my past self. Alright, and after we come back, that's when Timmy and Chin will be taking over. You guys will be heading to Food Cordia to take out the Sailor Moon girls and get some of their blood. Or DNA. Doesn't really matter. You can get any bodily function. Okay, and then after they come back, we'll be sending Jimmy and Sheen, the dynamic duo themselves. We'll be going to Amity Park, and once you guys go to Amity Park, you're going to find that ghost machine. It should be in Vlad's mansion, and if it's not, look for something. Maybe those souls might have a little bit of Imperium in them, too, so suck in as much as you can, but I would go for the ghost machine first.
Okay.
And that pretty much brings everyone to a halt, and once everyone's done with that, we'll bring those two back, and then we will all go in the time machine, because we'll have enough Imperium to basically conquer an entire continent, basically. And once we do that, we're going to come back, and we're all going to go to Volcano Island and get the last remaining bit of Imperium so we can fix that cursed tomb and make it a blessed tomb and bring everybody back. Everybody know their missions?
What are Timmy and the Crimson Chin going to do?
I already went over that. It's not my fault you weren't paying attention. Everyone got their plans? Everyone ready?
Yep.
All right, first team, front and center, SpongeBob and Patrick, you guys will be heading to Dimmesdale first. Get your asses in there! SpongeBob, Patrick, get in here. Good luck, guys. Thank you. Ah! All right, guys, you guys know the drill. Get as much Imperium as you can from those wands, or that wand, or whatever. See you on the other side.
All right. Hey, SpongeBob, is this going to be like that time we time-traveled Mermaid and Barnacle Boy and accidentally let Man Ray take over Bikini Bottom?
Maybe. All right, sending you guys in 3 seconds. All right, sending you guys in 3, 2, and 1. Alright, guys, moment of truth to see if they went back. Did they, Zim? I don't know. Opening the door to see if they're gone in 3, 2, 1. Oh my god. It worked, guys! Guys, it actually worked! They're gone! Hooray, I guess. Alright, now we just wait for them to get back. Shouldn't be too much longer.
Huh. So this is a comic book world.
Yeah.
Why does everything have these big black lines on it?
I guess it's supposed to look like an outline? I don't know. Come on, let's get this Imperium and get out of here. Where should we even look?
No idea.
Well, who are the aren't we supposed to be seeing Zim or, like, I mean, Ger and Timmy here somewhere?
Oh, yeah. And they were fighting, like, an evil Crimson Chin?
Yeah. Let's check downtown. That seems like a good place to start.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, do you know if garlic can kill a goat man?
Yes. Not the kind of question to be asking right now in this dire situation, Ger. Shoot at the Crimson Chin.
How do you think garlic can kill him?
I don't know. What now, Ger?
Well, I think we're doom 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 doom.
So what's a Sailor Moon?
Pretty sure it's an old anime.
Okay. I don't think we should let them see us.
Yeah, we should really be careful here. Okay, I think we're in the clear.
Okay, so what are we looking for again?
Well, I guess the main objective here is to look for... I guess Timmy and Gurr are here, but Timmy in our world was talking about how Cupid was looking over him because he's the guardian angel, but he's also the, like, the love god or whatever. So he's, mm-hmm. like, looking over Timmy to make sure he's okay. And we're supposed to be stealing his magic wand because all fairies have wands that are apparently made of some part Imperium.
Okay, yeah, but what is Cupid going to look like? Is he going to be wearing a diaper?
I don't know. I don't really know what the real Cupid looks like. Let's take a little thing around here. They said look somewhere downtown, so I'm assuming we're going to have to go into one of those buildings without being seen by those two. You know, doesn't look like they're doing much fighting when it comes to the evil Crimson Chin.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, I say we take a right down this next street. Okay, let's make a break for it. Let's go. I don't think
you hear. Hey, did you hear Gurr saying something about a goat man earlier?
I think so. I heard something about garlic.
Mm-hmm. But what's a goat man?
I don't know. Ask Sheen. He seems to know a lot about Gurr for some reason. Question is, which one of these buildings do you think Cupid might be on top of?
The tallest one?
Which one's taller, this one or that whitish-looking one right there?
Let's try this one first.
Okay. Door's locked. We're gonna have to scale the building. Patrick!
Huh?
Look. It's a comic book. See?
Oh, we can just climb up the outline. That's much easier.
I was actually flying because of imagination. Wait, I see someone. Ah! Patrick, he's on the white tall one. I saw someone with rings.
Yep. He has bird wings.
Sweet. Alright, Patrick, I have a plan. Here's what we're going to do. Come over here.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is we're going to go over there quietly. Without hurting him, I know you have a crossbow, but do not hurt him. We're going to go over there quietly, apprehend him, get his wand, and get the hell out of here. Understand?
Okay.
Patrick, what the hell was that?
Well, this is a tranquilizer gun. It was just supposed to knock him out.
Patrick, that's a crossbow.
Yeah, but I put tranquilizer darts in it.
Let me see that. Let me take a look. Patrick, the crossbow bolts. There's no tranquilizers. You just killed someone. Alright, whatever. Well, let's just go down there and get the wand.
Wand. Is this a wand?
Patrick, that's a pickle.
Oh, why do you have a pickle in his pocket? One. Is this one?
That's a clothespin.
What does it look like?
Here, let me take a look. Aha! Here it is.
Alright, so how do we get back to the present?
Okay, Zim told me to just contact him via walkie. You take the wand here. Follow me.
Hey, you hear someone falling earlier?
Yeah, I don't think we have time to go check it out, but the chin's distracted. Let's go see what it was. Patrick, let's get the hell out of here. We cannot be noticed. Oh god. Here, behind this gate by the blue crates.
So don't wait for me, this one is really heavy.
Alright. Zim, do you copy?
Read you loud and clear.
Bring us back. We're ready for team two. Bringing you back in 3, 2, 1. Are you guys there? We made it. Patrick, we made it. You have the wand?
Oh yeah, it's in my butt.
Okay. We made it! Congratulations, guys. Alright, now Plankton. Yes! Are you ready? Yeah, I'm ready as I'll ever be. Alright, you guys know what to do.
Hey, well, they're in New York. Can someone tell me what a Sailor Moon or a Goat Man is?
How about I explain it to you when Team 3 goes?
Okay.
Okay, sounds good. Plankton, we're up. Alright, we'll be in there for approximately maybe 10 minutes for you guys. But for us, it might take hours, like as long as we need. But if we're only in there for like a few minutes, you guys will see us in like 5 seconds. So, I guess that's how it works. Are you ready, Plankton?
Yes, I am ready.
Let's do this. Inside.
Let's get this bread.
Did you seriously just say that? You bet your sweet antennas I did.
Alright, we will be departing in 3, 2, 1.
Hey, Master, did you hear the portal open?
No, but we need to concentrate, Ticker. The Urkids are here, and Bloodiger is up there. Let's get to kicking butt! Alright, Plankton, are you ready?
Yeah,
I'm ready. Let's go. We're gonna have to look for a ship.
Speaking of ships, I know Ricky probably get one.
Where?
Well, when I read the newspaper and stuff, about the whole explosion and the destruction of New York, I read somewhere that a number of ships crashed around the city, like 15 in the old junkyard, but one really, really giant, really in good condition one over at some sewage plant.
Okay, then we'll check out the sewage plant. Follow me. Okay. The past version of me is right over there. Somewhere. There. With Gur.
Yeah? So are we gonna
head on over to the... Yes, but I was just admiring this. I haven't seen this place in quite a while.
Yeah, it's all great and everything. Yeah, whatever.
Let's go. Come on, I'll drive that truck.
Are you in?
Yeah, I'm ready to go.
So, Plankton, I haven't got to know you that much, and I know you're an associate of SpongeBob and Patrick's, am I correct?
Yeah, you're on the right track there. I actually don't like them. I mean, now I am forced to work with them because I want everyone to come back. And I've gained a lot of respect for them and kind of like them now that their old boss is gone. But they make it even more harder to steal the Krabby Patty secret formula, which you'd think would be weird because they're both imbeciles. But they are very, very, very hard to get past. Especially the big pink fat one.
Well, come on, we're almost there. We will get this job done, and we will make sure that everyone will be saved.
Whose truck is this even?
I don't know. Alright. get out. Alright, come over here. We're gonna hop on top of this truck. Ah, ah. Like so. And we're just gonna jump over the fence. Alright, let's see how we can make our way over there, because this sewage is highly toxic. You know what? What the hell? We only live once. Where'd you go? There. Hey, it's actually not that bad. Eh. It's not too bad, I guess. I mean, it's kind of burning my insides a little bit, but... Plankton? Hey. Plankton. Just meet me up top, okay? Meet me up top. Okay. That's a helicopter. There you are. I'm here. So what, we just suck out the Imperium? Yeah, you see these lights that are blowing out of the bottoms of the ship? Here, right here will do us good. I just reach my hand inside and grab some fuel, which are little tiny glass discs. Yeah. All right, where are you, Plankton? I'm over here. This is a disc of pure Imperium. Now, SpongeBob, Patrick, Timmy, all of you guys, bring us back. We're ready to be brought back.
Empty-handed. You thought you were being tricky. I see everything. I know everything. Those were from 2019, 3 years in the future. I don't think so.
So, were you guys okay in the past?
No. Yes, we did really experience too many difficulties. It was, quite okay. Okay, me and Shin are ready. Alright, you guys know what to do. Head on in. Alright. Transporting you guys in 3, 2, and 1.
Well, Zim, did they get out of there?
Yep, they're gone. Now we just wait.
Gurriger, where did you go? Where? You're in a load of trouble, Gur, and there's no way you're going to get any further.
It's still really weird that a deep man voice is coming out of a 14-year-old girl's body.
Alright. So, do we know what's going on here? Okay. I think I see that sailor girl, and I think I see Gurr under a bridge. Come on, let's go. Right behind you, Timmy. Hey! You! Random girl! Oh, God! And who are you supposed to be? A demonic kumquat? What did you do to me? I killed her. Alright, now I'm gonna use my wand and suck out the Imperium from her. This should be fun. I wouldn't hurt her. She looks like she could really tear our limbs off. She's dead. Doesn't really matter. Give me your Imperium. Alright, let's go. She only had 2% Imperium, though. I'm not sure this is going to help us in the long run.
Why do I hear Timmy?
Alright. Back up.
I check, but I'm too scared to get out from behind the bridge.
Alright, let's get out of here, Jin. Yeah, because it seems like Gurr's going to try and discover us. Let's get out of here. Alright, Zim, we're ready. Send us back. Sending you guys back in 3 seconds. Hey, did you notice that weird tuxedo guy siphoning out the fuel from the ships? I didn't. 3, 2, 1.
Timmy? Thought I heard him. Huh. Looks like this sailor went down with the ship.
Well, did they make it back? Here we are. We're back. We got the Imperium. It's in my wand. Perfect. Alright, you know what that means. Next group. That would be you. Sheen and Jimmy. Jimmy, why are you wearing a blue shirt? Well, I think it'd be better if me and Sheen kind of looked the same. Go put on your red stuff. It looks much better. Timmy, Chin, you can go ahead and put the stuff. Put the wand in my lap.
So, why did Gurr try throwing the Sailor Moon girls at the giant monster?
Alright, me and Sheen are ready to go. You guys know the drill. Go ahead and get inside. Alright, close the gate. Hey, Sheen, you know what I just realized?
What?
I made this time machine out of a shower.
Yeah.
Alright, sending you guys in 3, 2, 1. Alright, let me open the door to see if they're gone. And they're gone. Perfect. Now we wait.
That looks pretty bad.
Yeah, Danny warned me about the fog. It's dangerous, so don't let it touch your skin, because it apparently vaporizes you.
I thought it would turn you into a ghost. Isn't that like Danny's whole thing?
Well, yeah, but that's not Vlad's thing. He wanted to kill people so he could turn them into ghosts. But some people, I guess, don't turn into ghosts. They just...
Well, isn't that how you turn into a ghost? You die?
Not how Danny did it. Come on, we need to get to Vlad's mansion.
I thought Danny was only part ghost.
We need to get to Vlad's mansion, which I'm pretty sure is up this hill.
Okay.
Alright, come on.
Yeah, this is a really nice place.
It's huge. Danny did tell me a long time ago that his arch nemesis had the biggest house he had ever seen.
Well, Zim and Gurr lived in a hotel for a while. Isn't that pretty big?
Yeah, but that's a hotel. I mean, house-wise, it's pretty big. Alright, I have no idea where this ghost machine is, so let's just stick together.
Let's check the basement. Okay. The cool science stuff is always in the basement.
Where's the basement?
I don't know, but this is my best guess as to where it is, so let's... get the nails.
Follow me. Let's go explore the main dining hall area. This middle room right here. I only say stick together because this place gives me the heebie-jeebies. I mean, it is owned by a ghost, after all. If this place ain't haunted, I don't know what is.
I don't see anything in here. Jimmy, I think I found it.
Yep, that is definitely the ghost machine.
It's a big, swirly hall.
That's the ghost dimension. Or the ghost zone, as Danny calls it, I do believe. Don't flip that switch, please. We have no idea what that's gonna do.
Apparently it is switched to off, but it is still on.
I don't trust this. Let me do some computer analytics and see how much Imperium is made up of this whole wonky tunnel thing. You know, for a really big supervillain, I mean, I know Vlad's not a bad guy anymore, but back in 2017, this guy was a big supervillain, right?
Yep.
So he should probably come up with a better password than password. His system's code is so easy to crack.
Mm-hmm.
Holy
crap. Wasn't Professor Calamitous' password 123 !
I don't recall, but holy shit, Sheen. This ghost machine is made up of 65% of Imperium.
That's good, right?
That's amazing. We wouldn't even have to go to Volcano Island. We would just need this. Timmy, do you copy? Timmy, do you copy? Read your loud and clear. Hey, listen, we found the ghost portal thing in Vlad's mansion. I think it's... What would you call this, Sheen? His living room? Library? What would you call it?
Well, there's a piano, and then there are a bunch of books over there, and...
We found it in his library. We'll just put it at that. And we found the machine, but I'm not sure how we can suck out the Imperium. Well, here's the thing about that, Jimmy. You can't really do that, because in order to do that, you would need to have the, strength of a ghost and the power of it to absorb the energy from it. And that Imperium would kill you. It would probably kill the ghosts, too. So really, there's no way to get the Imperium out of there, which is...
Wait,
sad.
How can a ghost die? It's already dead.
It would move on, Sheen. Now please, be quiet. So what do you want us to do, Timmy?
Well, that's the bad news. Now there is a good news in this scenario.
Please enlighten us.
The good news being that there is apparently a ghost zone projector or something like that, like a ghost ray, that Danny has. But that, A, has less, significantly less Imperium than that machine you're looking at, and also you'd have to steal it from Danny, which is basically suicide. If a past version of someone sees you, you're more than likely going to die.
Oh, so this whole mission's a bust?
Not unless you can find that ghost ray without being spotted. Timmy out.
Shit.
Hey, Jimmy. Didn't we have some sort of invisibility thingy?
What?
I feel like I kind of remember us having something that made people invisible.
I don't remember. You probably remember more than I do. Come on, this whole thing's a bust.
But I might be mixing it up with this invisibility spray from Muppets in Space.
Okay. So, I don't know if you heard that conversation I had with Tim, but he said in order to basically get the Imperium we need, we'd have to go find Danny, 2017 Danny, and get a ghost ray from him. But chances are he's going to have it, and we're going to be spotted, which would result in a weird imbalance and something that would probably kill both of us if we were spotted. But it's worth a try, I guess. So I guess we're going back to the main city.
Okay.
Alright, Vlad. You've lost. You're not getting this ghost ray from me. No one ever will. I'm making sure that it's going to be locked up and safe forever. Come on, Sheen.
So, do you want to distract him while I grab the thing?
Are you sure you're up for this task?
Uh-huh.
Okay. There's some bottles right there I can use to throw them off.
Oh, and by the way, Jimmy, if I die, make sure I get a bigger grave than Carl.
Okay. You, here's what I want you to do. Let me get a closer look at what's going on. Okay. Danny's got Vlad pinned down. Run into the radio tower area. Not inside, but just at the gate. Walk up slowly behind him, or stay there. Stay at the gate by the radio tower until I throw the first bottle. When you see Danny start to notice and look around, that's when you go in for the kill.
Okay.
This should do. What the hell was that? What was that?
Yella!
What the hell?
You saw me, but I'm still YOLOing! Let me do the... Oh, you know what? Forget this.
Oh, God! Who the hell are you?
I'm trying to save the universe!
Go to the ghost zone! My arm! Sheen?
Yeah?
There you are. And Danny's on the ground. You did it.
Mm-hmm, buddy. Saw me.
He did?
Yes.
I'm sure he didn't see that much of you. I'm sure it'll be okay. Let's just go get the weapon.
Hey, Jimmy, what's the worst thing that could happen if you actually saw me for a long time?
Well, how long do you think you guys looked at each other?
I think, like, a minute.
Like a full 60 seconds?
I think.
Sheen, are you sure?
Probably.
Well, the worst that could happen is that while we teleport time travel back to 2022, you would have basically disintegrate and destroy the time machine, and I would get stuck in time loop. But on top of that, the people of the future would have no hope, and we would never come back, and they'd lose the battle.
That's all I need to hear.
Sheen, what are you doing? Sheen!
Regretting saying YOLO.
Sheen,
and
stop!
And a bigger grave than Carl.
Sheen! Sheen!
I don't know how I did that.
Sheen! Oh my God. What an idiot. Shane! Shane! Shane? Why would he... Shane? Shane, are you there? I can do this. I'm gonna land on that rock and not touch that fog. Sheen! Sheen!
Jimmy, this is Timmy. Jimmy, come in.
Read loud and clear, Timmy.
What the hell's going on? Why do you keep screaming Sheen?
Just send me back. I'm ready to be sent back.
Alright, send me back.
3, 2, 1. Jimmy. What, Sim? Are you okay? What happened? Where's Sheen? He killed himself. What do you mean he killed himself? He saw the past version of Danny. And he got scared, right? And I told him that it would compromise the whole thing. I made this time machine, and if he saw a past version of himself, it would mess up the whole time frame and the whole timeline, that maybe it would destroy the time machine and destroy our future. So I didn't want to scare him too much, but he scared himself and jumped off into the fog of souls and is now either a ghost or he's gone forever. Sorry to hear that, Jimmy. It's fine. Let's get ready. We need to go to Volcano Island. I got the machine gun too, so... or the ghost ray. Okay. I'm sorry to hear about Sheen. Shut up, Chin. You don't even know him.
Well, that doesn't mean he can't be sorry for you.
I don't trust him. He just shows up and automatically knows what's best for us. If he knew what's best, why didn't he try to, I don't know, do anything himself? You know what? That should have been you that jumped off into the fog of souls. Today has not been my day. In fact, this has just not been my past few years. My wife dies, my best friend dies, and now my bestest friend dies. It's just not my time. My parents are dead. I'm an orphan.
I'm sorry about that, Jimmy. But listen, we need to get the Tyrees and the Waterworks out of here right now, because we all gotta get ready for battle. We are all going to Volcano Island to retrieve some Imperium from Magu. Well, actually, I'd have to rebut that, Plankton. What do you mean, Zim? Here's the thing. In order for us to go, we'd have to have someone to send us there and bring us back. So one of us is going to have to stay. I'll gladly do it.
Chin?
Of course. I'd be happy to do it. If it means anything to make up for the death of your best friend.
Alright, so we've had this settled. We're all gonna go. See what we can do and bring back the Imperium, finish this off, remake the cursed tomb of Ramar after we go to Egypt, and then what?
Then we should bring everybody back.
Sounds good. Alright, everyone, go to your specific houses and get ready. Suit up, get whatever you need. We're gonna be gone for a while. Just because you're doing this does not make up for what you could have done.
Alright. Are you guys ready?
Yeah. Alright. Chin. Yes, Zim? So you know what to do. We're all going to try and squeeze into that little time machine. And you are going to set the coordinates for Volcano Island. 2017. Got it?
Yep, sure do.
Okay. Let's all head in there.
Alright, y'all, you guys all set in there?
Yeah.
Did you all fit?
Shockingly.
Alright, sending you guys. The coordinates are all set. Setting in 3, 2, 1.
Gosh, that's bright. Alright, let me open the door. Yep, they're gone. Now, time to reenact my evil plan. Let me set the coordinates and bring him back. 3, 2, 1. It's working. It's working. I'm bringing him back.
Okay, stop recording. Are you here, sir?
Sir, you look bright as ever. Mm-hmm. Where are the others? They've been sent to Volcano Island. They're going to get that last of Imperium, and then they'll be here with your Imperium, sir. They will never get a chance to rebuild that tomb now that you're here. Yes, so this is where they've been hiding out. Especially my father. Any idea what you're going to do with that Imperium, sir? Did you just question my tactics? No, sir, not at all. I didn't mean it like that. Well, I could tell you this. You're certainly not going to get any part of the Imperium. I'm going to use it to destroy the rest of the world. And with the leftover Imperium, I'll create a better world where I can all live with the people I'd want to be there. And you're not going to be there.
Why is that? Sir?
You're useless. One more shot. Let me reload. Such a pathetic excuse. And now we wait.
Hey, Chum Chum?
Yeah?
You want another rat?
No, I'm okay. I think we should leave, though. I don't know where this...
Agreed.
Let's just jump off this rock and see where it goes. It can't be too bad, right?
Yeah, maybe Kyle still has that bunker.
Yeah, let's go. Alright.
Hey, is it just me, or does Magu look different?
He looks like the same giant purple beast we saw when we were here.
Yeah, but he looks like a slightly different giant purple
beast. Nah, I think he's the same.
Why does he have holes in the tips of his fingers?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure he's always like that. Patrick!
What?
Remember this thing?
Oh yeah, the generator.
Yeah!
Alright, you guys, quit climbing around. Come over here. So, this is going to be a very dangerous mission. Because we are at the exact point where KFC the Third is about to come in. He'll come in about 45 seconds. So I need you two to be brave little souls and go over there and sneak behind one of those rocks and pluck a feather out of his ass. And once you do that, come back here. Because then we're going to teleport back home.
Wait, why do we need a feather? I thought we were going to get stuff from Magu.
Magu's skin is impenetrable. Remember we tried to hurt him, and the only way to hurt him was with KFC the Third's magical powers? Trust me, I'd love to get it from Magu, because he's a being of pure Imperium. But we all know that KFC the Third took him down, so he probably has more Imperium. And it shouldn't be that hard. You just can't be noticed by KFC, because all the others are knocked out. Uriah's knocked out, Danny's knocked out, they're all knocked out. Alright, he should have spawned in now, so...
Wait, wasn't Gurley...
Hurry, go!
You... Yeah.
You will never be able to stop me.
SpongeBob, be quiet.
Shh, shh, shh. Look, there I am. There's Zim. There's Gurr. They're all knocked out.
And there's KFC the Third.
Yeah, and there's SpongeBob. Looks like Sheen, Jimmy, and Timmy. What if we just bring this Sheen back? Never mind. And there's Uriah and Danny. Take this, you purple scoundrel.
Quick, SpongeBob, grab the feather.
Okay, let's go.
Let's get out of here.
Mission successful. Alright, good.
Let's go back home.
How much Imperium is in it?
Alright, let me do some calculations. It shouldn't be that much. Maybe like 20. Holy hairballs!
Well, what is it?
There's over 13 million points of Imperium in this!
Is that enough?
That's more than enough. We only need 100% Imperium, Patrick, and now we have 3 million? We should have just come here first. Alright, let's get in circle here. We need to tell Chin to bring us back. Alright, Chin, bring us back. Certainly, I'd love to bring you guys back.
Hey, that didn't sound like the Crimson Chin.
No, it didn't, but whatever. We got the Imperium. Let's go back home. Alright, guys. We did it. We got enough Imperium. Now we know what we have to do next. Let's head to Egypt.
But wait, what about the Crimson Chin?
He'll be fine. We can celebrate with him when we come back. Let's go. Don't you worry, Chinny boy. Once they come back here, we'll stop them. They can't do anything with that tomb unless they come where they want everything to happen. And there's no way they're going to want everyone to come back in Egypt. They're going to have to come back here. And when that strikes, that's when victory strikes. Victory for Caedem. Ah, we are here, finally.
So, who's gonna go get the tomb?
It's gotta be me, Patrick. I got this. You guys stay out here and keep watch.
There's so many people all staring.
Patrick, can you stop talking, please? Why don't you go help Zim? He might need some help.
Okay.
Ready, Patrick?
Yeah, but seriously, how did Gurr not get freaked out seeing all these people behind that fourth wall? All these people staring at us.
Patrick, I need to do this in utmost silence, please.
Okay.
Wait, the tomb is not this way. The tomb is this way. There it is. The broken pieces of the tomb. With the Imperium that we need, we can enchant the tomb and bring it back to life. Say the oath, and we can do this. We got this, Patrick. Come on, help me get these things back to Coral Coast.
Okay.
All right. This is where we use the Imperium refinery. That's when we put the Imperium in here. Inside the refinery. Like that. Perfect. Now, we turn on the refinery. Get it working. And now, we say the sacred oath. Let those who curse Ramar's tomb surely meet their untimely doom. Let those who worship Ramar's gate be blessed away from Satan's gate. Let those who perished as the others mourned all rejoice as they are reborn. Way to go, Zimmy boy. I think you did it.
Yeah, I think he did.
Way to go, Zim. Don't thank me. Thank Jimmy for making the time machine.
Look, Zim, they're floating. The tomb rocks are floating. Yes. Yes, they are.
Behold, ladies and gentlemen, the cursed tomb of Ramar has now become the blessed tomb of Ramar. What do we do, Zim? All we can do is hope.
Zim, I don't see Squidward or Sandy or any of the others coming back to life.
I don't see Sheen coming back to life. I don't see Carl or my wife coming back to life. Zim, what the hell's going on? Calm down. It could take time. We don't know.
Yeah, I don't know about that time thing, Zim. It should have taken effect.
Oh, shit.
What do we do now, Caedem?
On my signal, fire rockets at that red house. 3, 2, 1. Fire. Fire.
Wow, we're all the way out in the woods. That was some explosion.
Are you okay?
Oh yeah, I'm good.
The others are knocked out.
Seriously, this camera. This camera is a window. A window into a...
It's Caedem.
When can Gerd come back and take this fourth wall stuff? I don't want it anymore. It's creepy.
You too. Can't you just take off like all your other friends? Patrick, we gotta fight him. Come on.
Come on!
Patrick! Hello, Tubby One.
Yeah, look at me, I'm punching you in the face.
You're doing no harm to me whatsoever. SpongeBob, Plankton!
Yeah. Timmy. Never mind.
Patrick!
Caedem has really nice boots.
Boots? You're never going to be able to stop me. My army will be here momentarily. You two are pathetic. Zim? Patrick, is he okay?
Oh yeah, I think he's gonna be fine.
What are we gonna do?
Well, I suggest we all hide in Bikini Bottom, wait for him to finish destroying everything, and then when he's done and leaves, come back to the surface and repopulate the Earth.
I'm sorry, Zim. Looks like this whole cursed team thing was a
blowout.
Oh wait,
no. There are no girls here. So we couldn't do that.
I'm sorry, Zim. Looks like that her cursed team thing went down the shitter. I'm gonna go talk to my son. My pathetic excuse for a son. Good luck, Jimmy. Father. Yeah. You could not live with your own defeat. And where did that bring you? Back to me. Now. I'm assuming you haven't used that tomb yet. So, you're going to tell me where the Imperium is. Or I'm going to destroy this stubborn, stupid little planet.
Actually, we did use it.
Actually, Patrick, I think you should shut up. Did that tubby, fat tub of lard just say, you used it? You're damn right we used it. But to no cost. If you're gonna kill me, son, kill me.
Jimmy. Jimmy, do you copy? Jimmy, it's Carl. Do you copy? On your left.
Carl. Jimmy. Did it work? Did what work? I've just been asleep. It was like an hour ago, or maybe less. Maybe it was like 10 minutes ago or something. I was in Sandy's tree dome, and I woke up, and everyone else that was there woke up except you guys were gone. Oh. That's not all. Look. No way. What a mess. Jesus. 3 years inside of a tree dome will give you such a crick in the neck. Danny!
Where the hell am I? Yeehaw!
Damn it, SpongeBob. I thought I'd be having me sleep now.
Daddy!
No, it can't be.
Do we open fire, sir?
No. We gotta figure out a way to destroy those portals.
So much for high class.
Someone didn't pass their driving test. Alright, Zim. Just this once, I'll help. But don't expect any apologies from me.
Where's Tony? Oh, sorry, wrong universe. Strange, Dr. Strange, you sent me to the wrong place!
Guess I gotta lay off on bullying Timmy Turner to help.
Nicktoons
Unite.
I can't really see anything. Hey Dave, what were you saying about Gaz being anime again?
I don't know. Just keep shooting. Take this, you slimy sons of bitches. Cindy, I know. I woke up after a long nap, but let's focus on this, honey. Jezebel. I have no words for you, Jimmy.
Does anybody have a med kit? The spawn menu won't spawn me med kits.
Here, I got you.
Thanks, Jimmy. Also, no one spoil Stranger Things 3! I don't want to watch it myself! Hey, Master!
Zim? Or Gar? Gar?
Yeah, I found a corn chip in my head that looks like a balloon animal! I ate it!
Ah! Gar!
Hey, Master, I woke up on that urn planet, you were there, and then I found that balloon animal corn chip, and then Danny showed up!
What did Danny say?
He said some stuff that I didn't understand, and then I'm here, and hey, look, that cloud looks like death! Oh, wait, no, that's just explosions.
Come on, Gar, let's finish this.
Hey!
Where's your leader, you cowards?
He's probably hiding behind all of them.
Girl, are you okay?
Hey, yeah, I'm good.
That's all of them.
I'm gonna throw a grenade in the lake.
Gar, get out of here. It isn't safe.
Hey, Master, what do you think would happen if I threw a grenade in the toilet like that guy? Wait, Master, no! I was about to ask you what would happen if I threw a grenade in the toilet!
You guys are all pathetic. You may have taken out my army, but I am long from dead. My suit is keeping me alive still, and as long as it does, I will be stronger than all of you combined.
Well, we're all gonna die.
Don't you get it? I am inevitable. Wait, Zim! That wand is filled with Imperium. If you use that, it's a death sentence. I know what I'm doing. I am inevitable. Inevitable, you say, huh? Guys, wait. What's Zim doing?
Hey, Master, no!
What?
Don't do it! Chin, I thought that would be obvious.
Get out of my way. I am Zim. Patrick, what happened?
I think we won.
Sim, that's the bravest thing anyone's ever done. I had to do it. Otherwise, we'd all be screwed. You did a really good thing. You saved us all. We won. We won because of you. Gurr would like to say a few things. Come on, Gurr.
Yeah, My master, if you're dead, then who's gonna tell me not to make things explode?
Hooker, you'll figure that out yourself. Just don't do anything stupid. Please.
What? Oh, yeah.
Please. Just take care of everything. Make sure nothing bad happens.
Master? Are you gonna wake up?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are gathered here today to honor a fallen hero who seemingly saved us. So, please, let's bow our heads and pray. This man, this creature, was sent here to Earth for one reason only, and that reason was to destroy and take over this planet. Zim was sent here to seemingly invade, but he changed his heart. This brave soul put his life on the line to save all of us. Not only did he reassemble the cursed tomb and make it the blessed tomb, but he went out fighting like a hero. He used his willpower by using Timmy's wand and seemingly destroyed Caedem. Caedem is gone. And with that being said, we honor Zim, Earth's greatest hero. Now, I call Gurr to the stand to speak words about his master. Thank you.
Master was my master, and he was nice, and I'm gonna go.
We're all ready. Are you?
Yeah, just give me a few minutes.
Okay.
Where are his hands?
Okay, so I'm gonna record this real quick. For those of you watching this message, this is Zim, and this is one day before this whole cursed tomb thing is going to go down, before we're going to start time traveling and stuff. I managed to find time to sneak this little recording in, so I guess I might as well just play back this message. I'm recording this in case of an untimely death. Not that all death is already untimely, but you know what I mean. This time travel thing that we're going to pull off tomorrow has got me shaking my head, but I trust it. I have no idea if this Crimson Chin guy is really who he says he is. I have no idea. Maybe, for all we know, he's working with Caedem. We never know. But I do know something else. And that is, no matter what happens, I just hope to anything out there, if there's really a god or anything, that no matter what we do, the least we can do is bring everybody back. I want to be able to live in a world where maybe I don't get to live, but Gur does. Not only Gur, but the others that perished 3 years ago. I'd love to live in a world where we were all just together. And I know that's not gonna happen. God, what a world. Universe, actually. If you would have told me 12 years ago when I came here that I was going to instead be saving the Earth rather than invading it, I would tell you you're crazy. Because that is what it is. It's crazy. But now that I know that it's actually happening, I guess it actually... I don't know. I guess that's it. So, Gur, or anyone if you're watching this, please know that I'm glad you're alive. And if the others are watching this after I die and nothing's happened and nothing's changed, we lost. But otherwise, we won. Thank you. Zim out.
Bye, Master.
Everyone all packed up?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. Let's get the hell out of here. Home sweet home.
Yeah. I wonder if people on YouTube would like to see me play superhero games. Hey, SpongeBob?
Yeah.
What do you think we should do now that Uriah disbanded the unit?
I'd say we're just gonna live like normal people down here and, our normal fish. Sea creatures and just live a everyday normal life and do our jobs and make money.
Okay, then when are there gonna be customers?
I don't know, Patrick. I don't know. This is not what I imagined this would be at all. My wife broke up with me. And we're getting a divorce. Sheen and Carl want to move on with their lives. Sheen's married now. I have nothing anymore. All I have left is this new device. The clean slate. Now. I'm about 10 miles outside of Retroville City, so pressing the button on the clean slate should result in a permanent complete slate. I can reset the entire universe. I can turn back time to the day that this started, and I can make sure everything changes. I never have a son. I never caused the destruction of anyone, and we all live together, me and my wife happily. I'm gonna press this button and make sure everything is reset.
Let me make sure the time is right. Okay. This will reset every event since 2016. July 2016. Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What the hell? This didn't change anything. Fuck. Can't believe this shit didn't work. I reset everything for nothing. And now I'm gonna have to go home and be depressed. Vote Croza!
Hey, Master, I'm gonna go play Overwatch.
Why are you backwards, son? Or thing. Why are you backwards?
I learned how to moonwalk yesterday.
So you have to do that all the time?
Yeah.
Okay, girl, well, I gotta go do some stuffy stuff. If you get hungry, order some tacos from the telephone downstairs, and I'll be back momentarily.
Okay, Master.
Ah, life is good.
Oh, hey, Zem.
Hello there, random person.
I wanted to return a flash drive. The girl at me.
Who are you?
Neptune.
Oh, yeah. Gur talks about you all the time. Go ahead, he's upstairs. Playing Overwatch.
Okay. Hey, girl, I brought back your flash drive. I'm just gonna leave it on your dining room table. Bye.
Where did I put the Voot Cruiser?
Well, I guess this is life now. Life is a high. You're going my way. Something on I love. I don't remember the rest of the song. Ooh, a desert lizard.